Good morning, students. In our previous session, we have read page number 18 and 19 of chapter Fritz and have learnt about some of Jayanto's childhood memories other than his doll Fritz. By the end of this video, you will be able to understand what makes Jayanto believe that his doll Fritz had made those marks on the quilt, and how does Shankar plan to take Jayanto out of his fantasy about Fritz coming back. Now let us read page number 20 and 21. A road through the hills took us back to town. Who is us here? Shankar and Jayanto. Jayanto and I were both sitting in the back of the car. I offered him a cigarette, but he refused. I noticed a veiled excitement. Underline the word veil, children. Veil means hidden. So I noticed a hidden excitement in the movement of his hands. How come he noticed the excitement in the movement of his hands? One moment he placed them. What does them refer to? Them refers to the hands. So one moment he placed his hands near the window, then on his lap, and immediately afterwards began biting his nails. Jayanto was quiet by nature. Now Jayanto was otherwise quiet by nature, so this strange excitement of his made Shankar worried. This odd restlessness in him worried me. What is the meaning of odd, children? Odd means strange. So Jayanto was otherwise very quiet by nature, but this strange excitement of his worried Shankar. After about 10 minutes, I could not take it anymore. Who is I here, children? It refers to Shankar. So after about 10 minutes, Shankar could not take this anymore. So he simply asked, "It might help you," told me about your problem. So who says this? It is Shankar. Shankar asks Jayanto to tell him about his problem. Jayanto shook his head. Shook his head means he was dejected. He did not want to share. What was his reply, children? "It's no use telling you, for you are not going to believe me." What is the meaning of "for" here, children? "For" means because. So Jayanto tells Shankar that there is no use of telling anything to him. Why? Because he is not going to believe it. "Okay, even if I do not believe you, I can at least discuss the matter with you, can't I?" So this is how Shankar replies. He says, "Okay, if I will not believe you, I'll at least discuss what is the problem with you." So this next line, children, is very important. Mark it. "Fritz came into our room last night. Those little marks on my quilt were his footprints." Now you remember we have read it in the last page where Shankar said these can be the footprints of cat. Now Jayanto reveals that he thinks that Fritz came to his room last night and those little marks were made by the doll Fritz, right? "There was very little I could do at this except catch hold of him by the shoulders and shake him." Who is I again, children? It is Shankar. So Shankar, when heard this thing, he couldn't do anything except he would catch hold of Jayanto and he would shake him. "How could I talk sensibly to someone whose mind was so obsessed with such an absurd idea?" What is the meaning of obsessed, children? It means overpowered. And what is the meaning of absurd, children? It means strange. Now, of course, believing that a doll could come back and make footprints was an absurd idea. Therefore, Shankar shook Jayanto. Right? "You didn't see anything, did you?" I said finally. Who is I? Shankar. So Shankar asked Jayanto if he really saw anything. "No, but I could distinctly feel whatever was walking on my chest had 2 feet, not 4. That means it was not a cat according to Jayantu, as he could feel that thing had 2 feet, not 4 feet like a cat. As we got out of the car at the circuit house, I decided that Jayanto must be given a nerve tonic or some such thing. You remember earlier Shankar wanted to give a tranquilizer to Jayanto, but now he believed that Jayanto needed a higher dose than a tranquilizer, that may be a nerve tonic or something like that. A tranquilizer might not be good enough. I could not allow a 37-year-old man. Who is this 37-year-old man referring to? It is Jayanto. And who is I? Shankar. So Shankar could not allow Jayanto, a 37-year-old man, to be so upset by a simple memory of his childhood. What is this memory of? This is the memory of his doll, Fritz. I said to Jayanto upon reaching our room, "It's nearly 12 o'clock. Should we not be thinking of having a bath?" "You go first," said Jayanto and flung himself on the bed. So Jayanto lay on the bed and he wanted Shankar to take bath. An idea came to my mind in the bath. Whose mind, children? Shankar's mind. Perhaps this was the only way to bring Jayanto back to normalcy. What is normalcy? Normalcy means in a normal condition. If a doll had been buried somewhere 30 years ago, and if one knew the exact spot, it might be possible to dig the ground there. This is what Shankar was thinking in the bath, right? No doubt, most of it would have been destroyed, right? Because a doll obviously was a non-living thing, and if it had been buried 30 years ago, it would have been destroyed. But it was likely that we would find just a few things, especially if they were made of metal. So he knew that there would be some remnants, some pieces left of that doll, especially which ones were made of metal, such as the buckle of a belt or brass buttons on the jacket. If Jayanto could actually be shown that was all that was left of the precious doll, he might be able to rid himself of his weird notions. What are weird notions, children? Weird notions are his strange ideas. And what were those strange ideas? Those strange ideas were Fritz coming back to him, right? Otherwise, he would have strange dreams every night and talk of Fritz walking on his chest. If this kind of thing was allowed to continue, he might totally go mad. Now, this entire paragraph tells us that Shankar is planning to do something so that he can get Jayanto rid of his strange ideas, his weird notions. Jayanto seemed to like my idea at first, but after a while he said, "Who will do the digging? Where will you find a spade?" Now, what is a spade, children? A spade is an instrument which a gardener uses to dig, right? I laughed. Since there is a garden, there is bound to be a gardener. Of course, if there was a garden, a well-maintained garden, there had to be a gardener. And if there is a gardener, that means there will be availability of the spade. And that would mean there's a spade. If we offered him a little tip, children, some money, I have no doubt that he would have no objection to digging up a bit of the ground near the trunk of a tree at the far end of the lawn. Which tree do you think it is, children? It is the same deodar tree under which Jayanto had buried his Fritz. Okay? Now, Jayanto did not accept the idea immediately, nor did I say anything further. He went and had his bath after a little bit of persuasion. Persuasion means insistence. So Shankar kept insisting Jayanto to take a bath, and he went and took a bath. At lunch, he ate nothing except a couple of chapatis with meat curry. Although I knew, who is I, children? Shankar. although I knew he was quite fond of food. Now Jayanto was very fond of food, but he did not eat it as he used to. So he ate only a couple of chapatis with meat curry. After lunch, we went and sat in the cane chairs on the veranda that overlooked the garden. So they sat on the cane chairs on the veranda. There appeared to be no one else in the circuit house. There was silence around, right? And there appeared to be no one there. There was something eerie about the silence that afternoon. Now there was something eerie. Underline the word eerie, children. Eerie means something mysterious and frightening. So there was something mysterious and frightening about the silence that afternoon. All we could hear was the noises made by a few monkeys sitting on the gulmohar tree across the cobbled path. Underline the word cobbled, children. Cobbled means a path paved with pebbles. So you are to underline this complete two lines. There was something eerie about the silence that afternoon. All we could hear was the noise made by a few monkeys sitting on the gulmohar tree across the cobbled path. So this creates auditory imagery here. Okay. Around 3 p.m. we saw a man come into the garden carrying a watering can. Now who do you think this person can be? Of course, it was a gardener. He was an old man. His hair, mustaches and sideburns all were white. Underline the word sideburns, children. Sideburns are a man's side whiskers. Will you ask him or should I? So this question was raised by Shankar. Okay, so that is end for the session, children. Now you will read the same pages again. Thank you.